you're gonna wanna start by prepping your area. This is my least favorite part of the process, but it is important because paint is about to get on something. So just take the time to clear your space as much as possible. Afterwards, you want to go in and get some drop cloths. I think mine were fabric, but you can use like painter's plastic or an old fitted sheet, just whatever is best for you. And then you're going to want to gather your supplies to put on top of these, because as I said, paint's going to get on something and it's going to get on these drop cloths, and then you're going to end up tracking paint on your floor if you have to go get your supplies. So after that, music. Yep. Music is really essential because this is a long process, and music will keep you motivated to keep going and keep those creative juices flowing. So after you get your music, you got your little jams on, you're gonna have to go in and tape and cover anything left that you weren't able to move from your work area. You see me right now trying to go in here and tape some up. Struggling. Okay, anyway, so I'm going and I'm trying to do the trim, and I didn't do like the corners where the walls meet, but you're supposed to do that so you can keep the paint from getting on the other walls, but I didn't do that. I was just like, look, I don't like the prep, I don't like the tape. I'm just gonna not go close to these edges, and I'm gonna go back in with a paintbrush. But that takes a lot longer rather than just taping it up. But hey, to each his own. Now that everything is prepped and ready to go, it's time to get painting. Right now, you see me mixing the paint up because this is a gallon of paint, and typically gallons of paint separate after they've been sitting for a while. But other than that, this step is pretty self-explanatory. And just a quick tip for those of you who choose a darker color for this step, I would wait until you have painted the tree on already to do this step, and I'll explain that a little bit later in the video. So this is what I mentioned earlier. I have to now go in with a paintbrush to get all of the spaces that I wasn't able to get with my roller because I failed to tape. I mean, it didn't really bother me that much because I enjoy painting, but for those of you that do not want to do this and want to make this as short of a process as possible, I would suggest taping prior to, because this takes a lot longer than it would for you to just tape up. So step three is sketching out your tree's placement. You can do this by drawing lines to represent where your branches and tree trunk is going to be positioned on the wall. I would not recommend going in with any sort of detail or outlining because you're just going to be painting over top of this. Now you see me going in with marker. I would not recommend that anyone use marker because it's hard to cover a permanent black permanent marker with light colored paints. You could easily do this with pencil, which is why I also recommended that for those of you that are using your base paint to be a darker color, you wait until you paint your tree, because you will not be able to see any marker or pencil showing up on a black or dark blue background. This is it, guys. This is the time you've all been waiting for. It's time to paint that tree. This step is going to be so much easier, being that we previously sketched out what we want our tree to look like. All we have to do now is go in with the paint and cover up those lines. In order to get your tree to look more realistic, though, we have to start at the base. At the base, that's when you're going to designate how wide you want your tree to look, or how big it's actually going to come out. So you do your trunk about, maybe I want to say maybe about 4 inches or more, and then any branch that extends from the trunk is going to be maybe like an inch smaller than that, and any branches that extend from those branches are going to be an inch smaller than that, so on and so forth, just to make it look more smooth and more like a tree. I really hope that makes sense. That's the best way I felt like I could explain it for you guys to understand. So hopefully that makes sense. So this step is optional. Basically, you're just stepping back and deciding whether you like your tree as is, if you need to add any branches anywhere, taking any branches away. I obviously went in and decided that I needed to add some to make it look more full. So this is all based on you and what you feel and your point of view.
OMG.
Anyways, for those of you that decided to do a dark base paint, now will be the time to go in and do so. All right, so lastly, we're gonna go in and add flowers, or you guys could do leaves. This had to be the longest and hardest part of this entire process, because I am using a circle sponge brush to dab around the extremities of the branches, the smaller parts, to create the effect of bunched up flower. I just wanted to add this in. You see me going in now after some time and covering up this mess that I ended up creating, because I started to get so frustrated with this tree. Well, with my tree, I started to add the flowers, and then I started to add more flowers and more flowers until it was just too many for my liking. I started to get more frustrated with it. I didn't like it as much because I was adding so much. So if you're the type of person that thinks less is more, really take your time and space them out how you want to have them spaced out, so you can come out with a beautiful looking tree rather than this mess that I ended up having to go back in and cover up. So after all of that, me having to cover up all of that pink, I went back in and did basically the same steps, but this time I tried to take my time. I didn't add as much pink, and then after I did the pink, I added in some white to make the other colors pop, and then I went back in with some more pink. But other than that, everything else was pretty much the same, and it came out gorgeous. I love it.
So that's all I got. Let me know what y'all thinking.